Yeah, that's a harlequin. I can see it. It's got a harlequin in it. Harlequins.
No, that's not a harlequin.
No. It's a harlequin.
I'm sorry, but that's not a harlequin.
That is a harlequin.
You're dreaming. That is not a harlequin.
That's a harlequin.
That is not a harlequin.
That has got to be a harlequin.
I'll tell you now. That is not a harlequin.
Today we're going to be talking about opal patterns. Opal patterns.
I'm Justin and this is Black Opal Direct. My family have been teaching and exploring opal since 1961. Click the subscribe button and enjoy as we dive into the best gem in the world, black opal.
So today I've chosen a whole bunch of stones with similar patterns to show you that many patterns can look slightly different but still be the same pattern. Now I've chosen Flagstone Pattern as the first pattern for us to go through because I find a lot of stones, a lot of nice gems have Flagstone, and I would like to explain to you that Flagstone can look different but still be considered Flagstone Pattern. So I'll just get into it. I've picked out some of the nicest gems that I've got in my stock, and I want to show you what I mean by Flagstone Pattern. So for instance, this stone here, you can see there's little flakes of color. This is a flake of color. This here is a flake of color. There's more flakes of color. That's a flake of color. So you can see that there's, as I move it around, there's another one there, that there is lots of flakes of color and they're all pretty much joining up in this stone. Now it doesn't have to happen that often, all the time, that they join up, but that is like a flagstone paving, flagstone ground. It can be even bricks or it can be uneven bricks or pavers. So this is the reason why they call it flagstone, and that's a good representation. Now I'll show you another stone here. Now while this has got some pinfire pattern here, there is some smaller pattern there. You can see the larger flakes, a larger flake there, and as you move it around, there, they are all flagstone pattern. And so now this one has a little bit more depth to it, but so there's color underneath the higher pinfire pattern, and underneath there is some flagstone pattern showing up. So you can see it there and underneath there, showing up there a little bit on the edge there. That's another one there. So this is another form of flagstone pattern. So that helps. This one here, you can see now it has that magical blue red, and the blue red is probably the most rare color combination in opal. But you can see in this one also, there's a flagstone. There's a multicolored flagstone right there. And there's one there, one there. So you can see that most of this is flagstone. Now it's more flagstone on that side of the stone than this side of the stone. This stone side starts becoming a little bit more sheen and floral sort of pattern. Now this one here is another nice stone that's in our stock, and you can see that it has flags as well, so flagstone. Don't get it mistaken with flag and flagstone. Flag pattern is different to flagstone. This is a flagstone pattern there. There's a little one there. So there's one there. It's in a funny shape, but it's still considered flagstone. There's another one there. And you can see this here is a little bit of broad flush pattern happening on the edge, but because it's part of all this, I would consider the whole thing as flagstone pattern. You can see that one flag right in that flagstone right in there too. So there's some really good examples. This one here is a perfect prime example of flagstone pattern, and it's double-sided, and you can see very clearly those flakes of color. Now this one, you could consider this pattern as well as cloverleaf pattern as well as flagstone, because some of it does look a little bit like clover leaves. But I would just pretty much name it flagstone because there's some beautifully segmented flakes of color, especially on this side. You can see it very clearly. There's little web lines between the color flakes. So that's a very distinct color flake. And there's one there, one over there. So you can see that that is Flagstone Pattern. The next pattern I'm going to share with you is called Floral Pattern. Now, Floral Pattern is a little bit different to Flagstone Pattern. You can see in this stone, see, you do have some flakes of flag in there. So this is a Flagstone Pattern, and that's sort of a flag. No, not really. That's a Flagstone Pattern. But when you start to get clusters of color all mixed up together, like they are, you consider that Flagstone Pattern. Let me show you another example. So you can see there is a little bit of Flagstone Pattern there, but it moves around and there's a lot, like there's clusters of color, flakes of color. This is what you would call Floral Pattern. So if you think of a bouquet of flowers and you see a nice bunch of flakes of color everywhere from the flowers, it's very similar to this. So if you were to see this here, looks like a bouquet of flowers. So you would consider this sort of thing Floral Pattern. Another example is this one. So there is some bits of Flagstone Pattern, but it's mixed in with other color. So you're going to consider this as Floral Pattern. Now, if you were to look really closely into these stones, you could, you know, name it, that's floral, a flagstone, then there's floral, then there's chaff, there's like a whole different heaps of patterns if you could delve too deeply into a stone. And I don't believe you actually should. I think you should just go with what the predominant pattern is in the stone, or a mixture of two predominant patterns. I wouldn't go to make out that there's, oh, it's got chaff, harlequin, you know, so many different patterns, because it gets confusing and it's pretty much untrue. So this one here, you can see there's also some Flagstone Pattern in there, but there's a lot of mixture of things going on. So this could be a whole bouquet of flowers there. There also. So you would, and this has also got a little bit of depth to it, this stone. So you would consider this flagstone slash floral pattern. If you were to get really technical, that's what I would call that. So there's five different styles of floral pattern. And you can see that all of the gems look different, but they have a similar kind of pattern for the most part. Now, here's another type of pattern that I only have one of right now, and that is called ribbon pattern. Now you can see in this ribbon pattern, let me just wipe it with a cloth. You can see this ribbon pattern, you can see exactly why it's called ribbon pattern, because those flakes of color, which you could consider a flagstone pattern, or you could call it flagstone ribbon pattern, or ribbon flagstone pattern. You can see the pattern rolls across in the segments themselves. So this here is the whole flagstone, but because this color rolls with the stone back and forth like that, that is considered ribbon pattern. And when you look at the whole stone, you see every single flake of color moving as I move it, like it's coming from a nuclei here. If you wanted to get really technical, you could call this a stereo pattern, where the color comes out. But a stereo pattern usually has the nuclei in the center, and then the colors come out from the middle of that. So this is much more closer to rolling ribbon pattern, or ribbon pattern, or flagstone slash ribbon pattern. So there you go. So the next pattern that we're going to look at is chaff pattern. Now, chaff pattern looks like a scratch, like a bear scratch on a tree, and you can see it in opal. Now, chaff pattern doesn't usually show up on all of a whole stone. Like, it's very rare for chaff pattern to be right across the whole stone. So as you can see in this piece, you can see there's a whole bunch of floral pattern here. There's some flagstone pattern there. And these three little lines, that's called chaff. There should be more chaff in there, but let's find it. Just get the cloth onto it. Make it a bit shinier. And we'll find, there we go. There is some chaff pattern. See these three lines here? This is what you would consider chaff pattern. Now that is in a flagstone flake of color, and a lot of this side of the stone is flagstone. So you could call that flagstone slash chaff pattern. So let me give you another example in another stone of flagstone. Chaff, we're into chaff again. This one has a nice broad flash pattern. You can see that broad flash is amazing, but we're not looking for that. We're looking for the chaff pattern, which is sitting here, which are lined like a scratch. And there's, so you can see in some stones, they're very, very distinct chaff pattern. Now this one's, you know, kind of hard to see it. You can see there's a little couple of lines there as well. They would be considered chaff. When you get those lines crossing over, like all over, then you start getting into script pattern. But this is chaff pattern. Let me show you on another stone. This one's a bit more distinct on the chaff pattern. You can really quite see it really well. This is a nice piece of chaff pattern. This is a nice chaff pattern. You can see the scratches there. And also, it is flagstone chaff pattern. You can see that just about everything in this stone has scratch lines in the pattern. So let's look at one more stone. And this one has very distinct, it's got a very broad flash pattern there, but then you've got this very distinct three scratches right there, which is pretty much chaff pattern. Now, if you look at this stone from the other angle, you can see here as well, lines going this way. That is also a form of chaff pattern. It's very difficult to get it out of this stone, but I think it pretty much explains itself what is chaff pattern. Okay, so a double up on a couple of the stones, just to show you, because there is another pattern in some of the stones we've already seen. So now we're going to concentrate on broad flash pattern, which is a pattern that usually spreads across the whole stone. So you can see this stone, we've already looked at the chaff pattern in there, but we can also look at that red. See that red going across that stone? That is what you call broad flash pattern, because it's pretty much goes right across across the stone, and is very distinct. Now, broad flash can sit with other patterns very, very often. So you will get a broad flash, and you'll usually get some patterns over the top of that broad flash pattern. And here's the other example of the broad flash that we found the chaff pattern in this stone as well. But when you look at it from a certain angle, you can see that it's got broad flash pattern. So that pattern going right across the stone is what you would consider broad flash pattern. Now there's patterns in between that broad flash pattern that show up, right? So it kind of crosses into two or three different patterns, but there is an underlying glow that goes across the stone and reaches out the whole way, which is pretty much broad and broad across the whole stone. Now this one's pretty much an example of broad flash that has really no other patterns in it. So you can see that it stretches right across the whole stone and really doesn't get inhibited by any other pattern whatsoever. So that is a really prime example of a broad flash pattern. So you will see many, many listings on the internet that say the opals are harlequin. And people just mostly use that word to try and sell their opal, which they're actually doing themselves a disservice, because they're confusing the opal community, for one, and they're making themselves look stupid. Because Harlequin opal, there's probably maybe five on the internet at the moment. that would be considered Harlequin pattern. And Harlequin pattern is a very, very rare type of pattern that you can't just call any old stone Harlequin. And if your Harlequin opal has one square of color or two squares of color in it, that's not considered Harlequin, not at all, by a long shot. That's still Flagstone. Harlequin is a pretty much almost replica of a checkerboard pattern. So checkerboard is like a chessboard, and you gotta get squares of pattern like that in order to consider it Harlequin. Now anything around that will be considered Flagstone because they are like Flagstone pavers. So I don't even have a Harlequin in stock right now to be able to show you what it looks like, but I can give you a few examples like this. Okay, so the last pattern that we're going to go through is Pinfire Pattern. So there's a little bit conjecture about what is Pinfire Pattern and what is not. And when you look at a stone and you look at the size of it and you look at the size of the flakes of color. Okay, so this stone I showed you earlier with the Flagstone pattern, and it has some Pinfire Pattern over the top. Now, if you magnify this pattern here large enough, it turns into Flagstone pattern. And so you have to be really careful about how big the Pinfire pattern is in conjunction with the size of the stone. So for instance, this stone here is a perfect example of Pinfire pattern because there is so much going on, really tiny dots of color, and very pretty stone, but you can see, and the closer you bring it, you could see if I was to magnify that, that would turn into Flagstone pattern. But because we're looking at the stone further back, we can see from with our naked eye that it looks more like pinfire. So the same with this one. If I hold it up really close, it looks like Flagstone pattern, but if I'm holding it far away, then you would consider the middle of that stone as Pinfire pattern. This one here, from a distance, it looks like Pinfire pattern, and up close, it looks a little bit, it still looks like Pinfire pattern, but it could also look like moss pattern as well. So Pinfire pattern is small dots of color, and this one is the most recognizable Pinfire pattern that I have at the moment. So hopefully that helps. Well, there you go. There's quite a few patterns I've gone through. Hopefully it helps you out to understand opal a little bit better, because opal can be really difficult to understand. And when it comes to pricing, the pattern does play a big role, as well as the brightness, as well as the cut, the size, and the color combinations. There's so many factors, the body tone. So we will go through that again over the next probably 6 months. We'll go through different parts as well as cutting some other opal. So I hope you enjoyed that, and I'll see you next week. Thanks for watching.